is our first class and it is the introductory class. So we just were going to discuss some introduction about how to study this biology and what is the methodology to study thoroughly. Because in the 10th class, what happens, there is just one book, a little bit about the physics, chemistry, everything is given. But when you come in the 11th class, you have a separate physics, chemistry, and biology. And syllabus is more than 12th in the 11th. Diversity of the subjects and matter is there. So before to start this biology, generally, we study the differences between living and non-living. Generally, it is us. But here I am to discuss what is the similarity or similarities between. Just reverse, I am asking you. Similarities between living and non-living. Generally, it is student study the differences. I am not asking difference. I am asking about the similarities. If any of you want to share, you can raise your hand and share with me. Otherwise, I will start. See, what is the similarities? See, what I would like to tell you. So if you have a notebook, you write down the similarities and just discuss with me. It is an introductory class. Here, suppose here is an organism, any organism that you might have studied. Suppose we are human being, organisms. You know these organisms are made up of, we all are made up of organ systems. We have a systems, digestive system, circulatory system, cardiovascular system, cutaneous system, skeletal system, lot of systems are there that combine to form organism. And the systems are made up of, you know, perhaps tissue. I think you know it. And tissues are made up of, if you want, you can share with me, cells. It is plant cell or animal cell. These are the cells combined to form tissues. And cells are made up of
cell organelles,
mitochondria, etc., combined to form the cell. It is made up of tissue, of course, okay. It was the cell. Just one minute. Tissues are made up of cell, and cell are made up of cell organelles. I'm taking another color. And can you tell me cell organelles are made up of? Here, our interesting part is here. Cell organelles, whether it is mitochondria, Golgi, ribosome, everything you have studied.
Atoms.
All are made up of? Made up of?
Atom.
Pounds. No.
Oh.
Pounds. I have changed the color. Compounds are made up of? Elements. Yes. Up see where we are. Elements are made up of? Atom. So now children, think differently. Generally, people say, oh, this is living, non-living. But think, up to this, this is the similarities between the living and non-living. This is the similarity. Here, these matters, that is, you study atom in physics and chemistry. If you think, oh, sir, I know, an atom consists of proton, neutron, surrounded by electron. Everything is present in your body also. If you don't know at this level, then we cannot understand the element. We don't understand element. We cannot understand the compound. If we don't know the compound, then we can't know cell organelles. We have just not to go ratte lagana. No, not at all. We have to understand. Each and every point, we have to understand what is happening in a cell. It's a mini chemical factories. Large number of reactions are going on. You have to understand at every point. So, see here, these atom element compounds, they, at this level, biology and chemistry are the same. Biology, chemistry, even we are calling atom, the physics is also the same. But what is the difference now in the living system as a level of organization? This is the important point. Level of organization. Level of organization, that is the important thing. In the non-living, this compound could be there. Your toothbrush is made up of a compound. Your switchboard is made up of compound, but they can't work like this. You're using car, they are the compounds, different parts, different compounds. But here the compounds get arranged in such a way, such a beautiful way, that forming cell organelles, and then they form cell. This is the living unit of the living. So we have to understand here. So question is there, how and which compound? Compound make us living. Not all compounds are present in our body. You cannot find the compound of the gold. The compound from which the cells are made of is collectively called as biomolecules. Its introduction you will get in chapter number one. Only introduction. But detail of the biomolecules are given in chapter number 9. Our chapter number 9 is a combination of all. Combination of all. So, is it clear, children? If you want to take the screenshot, you can take it. Or you want to note it down, note it. And in between, if you have any curiosity, you can raise the question. I am repeating, it is our introductory class. How to study biology. So a question arises, from which biomolecules we are made of. All number of elements have been discovered, but not all elements are found in our body. There are specific elements, they are found in the human body. Certain are common both plant and animal. Certain elements are common that we will study differently in the plant. In the human, compounds are also some different. Let us talk about this biomolecules, which is present characteristics of the living. So which compounds are present? We are discussing the compound that which in our syllabus or we should know first. And all of you know that biomolecules consist of, you might be aware about protein. Can you share with me another type of biomolecules? Carbohydrates. These all are in our syllabus in some chapter. But in early, we should understand about it. Then lipid oblique fat. Nucleic acids. I think you know about the nucleic acids. It is top of two types, just you know the name. RNA. Nowadays we are, all human peoples are get disturbed due to COVID virus, COVID-19. This, it has genetic material, it is RNA. Only RNA and protein is there, see here. Only RNA and protein is there, and how it become the enemy of the human. Later we will think. This virus is consist of only protein and RNA, and they are killing the human being. Now, fifth, beside these compounds, we have in the living system, we have certain minerals. Minerals, sodium, zinc, and iron, many minerals that we have to study. Then again, compound vitamins. Vitamins is also a compound. Elements, you chapter, this fifth is not the compound. And last but not least, is the water. So these compounds ultimately make us living. And that we have to understand biology, that how the various chemicals organize to form our structure, they form our body, head, bone, everything is made of. We can see that our eye is also in a compound. And thousands of reactions are going on inside the body. So that always takes place due to these compounds. Now I will, just introductory, I will talking about the one protein. If children, you have any question, you can raise, note it down, or you can ask. So if you want to write down, you can take the screenshot. And I am not erasing it. It is on, I am on another page. So all you know, let us talk about little bit, we will talk about the protein. In 10th class, you might have studied protein just as a building material. And you know this COVID virus kills the human being due to this special protein. It can kill also. Use a special protein, kill the humans. This is spike. This is also a protein that kills. A snake venom is also a protein that kills the human. That we will talk. Your hairs is also made up of protein. Your enzymes is also a protein. Enzymes is also a protein, and that breaks the protein also. Anyway, proteins are made up of its unit called as, any Chinese student? Suppose our whole wall, this whole wall is made up of, suppose it is a protein. Then one brick is the amino acids. Its unit is, I think you might have heard this name, amino acids is a unit of protein. It is of only 20 types. Only 20 types. And see, only these 20 types combined in a specific way that make the human, that make the bird, that make the snake, that make the plant. Gradually, we have to understand how these different amino acid combines and form a specific thing. Anyway, let's say first see it's little bit about this chemistry. Little bit. Heading you write down, we are on the amino acid. Now see how you are making, you will make a structure, amino acid. See it's, now you note it down, general chemical structure. General chemical structures. You may ask from where I am talking. So I am talking about your chapter one, page number 5. I am also talking about chapter number 9, page number 143, 144, and 145. If the question comes in your mind from where it is in our book, so I am telling you, it is always first chapter, page 5, chapter number 9, here it is. Ab say, how will you remember? Generally, a student go through the name. No, try to understand. I am discussing the general chemical structure of an amino acid. So what is given here, see, you all of you know about the methane. In 9th, 10th class, you might have heard this name, methane. This is the methane, I think you all are aware. From this car, keep the carbon here. Remove this hydrogen and in place of this add carboxyl. This COOH you might have studied, carboxyl, carbonyl group. And remove this hydrogen and here you add amino NH2, perhaps it is not in the 10th, perhaps. I am not fully aware, this is NH2, NH2 is called as amino. If you don't know, you write down amino. There are two functional groups, just like aldehyde and ketone, carboxyl and amino are here. This H remain as it is, no change, that is from the red. And for this H, I am writing R. So this is the general structure of an amino acid. What is there? Suppose this is the neck is the carbon, capital red carbon. One hand there is a carboxyl, another hand is an amino. Then what you will keep the name? Amino acid. Always in any amino acid, there is one side, one hand there is amino, another has carboxyl acid. That's why it is called as amino acid, always amino acid. This H is fixed and you know R is variable. If you change the R, the name of amino acid will get changed. Have understood? The central, suppose this is my neck, is this carbon. My neck is this by carbon. Again, I repeat, one my hand is amino, another is carboxyl. My this body, this is the H, and this my head is R. If you change it, don't try to change my head. If you change it, amino acid will get changed. So first you draw it, I am giving you some introduction, hints to make a structure of certain amino acid that you can do. Keep ready with pen and pencil. Any student has question? 8 minutes. Someone is asking question. Olivia, do you want to say something? Your hand is up. Anyway, Sachi, Raisa, is it okay?
Sir, what have you written beside COOH?
You have understood this general chemical structure or not?
Yes, sir.
So now I am, if you have understood it, that there will be no change in this structure. Only if you know the R, you can make certain amino acid. That first you make, then I will give you the page number, you will check that no way, give pressure to memorize. So here I'm writing the name of certain structure of certain amino acid. I'm writing structure of certain amino acids. You know the general structure is this one, all of you know. Only you have to change this NH2, this H, it is fixed. Only you have to change here. Here I'm writing the name of certain amino acid which is in certain page in your book given at one place. That is, some of you might be knowing, or some of you might be knowing first time, glycine. Second one is alanine and serine. I think these all are your new friends. If you feel that, how shall I remember? I'm writing simple way gas. Suppose a gas is leaking from your kitchen. This G stands for glycine, A for alanine, and S for serine. What you have to do, this structure will be the same in all case. I am just writing this value of this R. You have to change this one and you will make the structure. Value of R. For glycine, R is simple H. For alanine, it is simple CH3. Means here you have to add CH3, it will, a structure will be alanine. And serine, CH2OH. This one you have to add here. I'm giving you 3 minutes, draw the structure. If you have done, then you tell me, sir, I have done.
So we have to draw the structure for three of them.
Yes, all three, because we have understood these, all these are the same. Only you have to change this one. See, and I'm helping you. This is okay. It will be not changed in any case. It will be not changed in any case. I'm not doing anything here. Only you have to add H here. See here, this is my neck. One hand is my carboxyl. My another hand is amino. My whole body is H. See here. My another hand, amino and H. What I told you, just you have to check this H is here, just you add H. This whole structure become glycine. Now you have to add here this one. It's become alanine.
Done.
You have done very good. Now check if this is become CH2S. You have made these structures.
Yes, sir.
If you have a book, turn your page number 145. And in top, you see the structure. The same three is given or not here. Here, here, here. Check if you have a book, page number 145, these three structures are given or not.
Yes, sir.
It is given. So now it is okay. Just you have to understand. Everywhere we have to understand, accepting the certain scientific name, no rectification, no, only we have to understand. When you eat protein, in 10th class you might have studied digestive system. So what we have studied in digestive system? Let us talk about that. When you eat protein, you might have studied it converts to amino acid. I think you remember or not?
Yes, sir.
You remember. Now see how you have to study. Should I erase it? It is already given. If you know the technique, So all gradually I will give the technique and you will remember all 20. Only this body you have to know, and by some technique you will remember this value, or we can make it. So you have studied 3. What is the name? Can you repeat with me?
Glycine, alanine, serine.
Repeat it again, all you. Glycine, alanine, and serine. What is the value of R for glycine?
H.
For simple H. This one. I am asking this value. For glycine, it is H. For alanine, CH3. And for serine, CH2OH.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can we write NH2?
No, that will be no. If we will change the H, the structure, R structure will get changed. You will not add anything. See here, all full valency is okay. This is important. You can't change it.
Instead of marking 2H with N, can we simply write NH2?
That you can write. In the latter, we will write NH2. It is your beginning, so I am writing in such a way. It is our beginning. The latter, we will write NH2. No problem. But suppose I am asking you another thing. And then you correlate how this you eat in 10th class, you have, might have studied you eat protein, right? And what is the difference in 10th and higher class? In protein, here the enzymes work in our digestive system. Can you name the enzymes that work here?
Trypsin, pepsinogen,
carboxypeptidases, and so many. And it converts into the amino acid. And it comes in our body. It's simply that you have studied in the 10th class. But now how will you study? See here. Suppose a whole railway track bogie, whole train is the protein. Whole train is a protein. Then each and every bogie is an amino acid. Suppose whole train, your Rajdhani Express, is a protein. And your one bogie is the amino acid. When you eat, suppose you have taken the whole train, then the bogie is cut and enters our circulatory system. Now see what happens. Here I am writing the joining of amino. I am discussing this one again. Here you write down the heading joining of amino acid. Joining of amino acid. And how we have to study here in digestive system. Suppose two bogie in the train get joined with a very special structure. And when you eat protein, you are eating a long chain. So how they two get joined? See here. I'm writing R. It could be anything. This is the one amino acid. Later you will write this one. This is from the different color. For your understanding, I am making another amino acid. This is amino group. This is H. This is carboxyl. Now tell me, you might have heard the name of in 9th or 10th about the ribosome. And you all have studied ribosome makes protein. So what actually ribosome is doing? Ribosome makes this reaction between this carboxyl, OH and H, combines together and release a water molecule. See here what happens. OH of this or H of this combines and release water, then what happens? This H is as it is. Now if you wish, we can write NH2. Here this carbon is here. this oxygen is here, and I have used different color. Where are these N has come? This N and H combines. And then this one, now see how the amino acid combines. Now they combined by this one. This bond is called as peptide linkage. Peptide. This word you will get later on at 150 or 51. So actually, bachche, what happens? This ribosome makes the reaction between carboxyl amino and make this bond. And just you told me, some of you told about the digest enzyme, trypsin, pepsinogen. The function of this enzyme to add a water molecule here. What is digestion? They add a water molecule here and these two separates. This is digestion. So you have to study now the when you will come in the digestive system, you have to understand in this way. When you eat a protein, your digestive enzymes just adding a water molecule between the each, in between the peptide bond, this gets separated. And it enters in the body, different part. It is in your lungs, it is in your pancreas, it is in the brain. When the cells needs a protein, this ribosome make them join and make the protein. This is happening. So now just think, what is the importance of this chemical and compound or the biomolecules? Without this, how can understand digestive system or this anything? When you will understand all the chemicals, you can understand very easily. Of course, after introduction, we will start from the chapter number one. No problem in it, you will start from there. But one must have the idea in the mind how we have to study. Suppose in chapter number one, you will get a word, metabolism. If metabolism is given, then simply in chapter number one, how this student understand the metabolism? This is one of the part of metabolism. Formation is also a metabolism. Breakdown is also a metabolism. Then you can understand easily in chapter number one, this metabolism is of two types, anabolism and catabolism. Formation and breakdown is catabolism. That's why this introductory class is very important to understand our goal, how we will go through the biology. So any question from this part, student? Have you understood?
Me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, so basically this was an introductory class for biology and not first and ninth chapter.
Yes, no, it is certain part in your chapter number one. In chapter number one, you will cross this word, only metabolism, right? But how can I explain what is metabolism? So simple, in the first introductory class, you will know about this one. I told you very earlier, we all are made up of chemicals. So until you know some these chemicals, then how will you focus? Now, of course, you will start from chapter number one, but it will remain in our mind. You have to study at that level. Because if you are going to prepare for the NEET, then concept is required, only concept. And if you have a concept, you will never forget what is happening. If you will just go through the name, you will forget it. So you have to remember anything in easy way. Like that, you never forget cat and dog because you're repeating many times. But you cannot recall an uncommon animal of the sea because you are not aware of that. You have to make the chapters easy. Any questions from this part, students?
No, sir.
Next, we will start. This part. This is your first chapter. This living word, I think some of you might have studied. Up see here. Here they are discussing about the word metabolism. Yes, see here, the chemical reactions, see here, what they are using. Metabolic reactions. Up suppose here, this is the metabolism word is here. Metabolic reactions are word as given. So how a student can understand is this chapter? So what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this? What in the metabolism? See here. Of course, in between, we have to say something about this chemical reactions occurring in our body is a metabolism. Just going through the term is not enough. So just wait. So now let us talk something about the protein. Would you like to make the structure of some of these other amino acids? A few amino acids. Now you tell me, student, do you want to start from chapter number one now? So see, if we have to start from here now that I have started, if you don't have books in here, then here there is a discussion. So what is the difference between living and non-living? Just a minute. So question arises, what is living? So from the introductory part, we have seen that this compound makes the cell organelles and that forms the cell. So your cell is the structural and functional unit. Cell become a structural and functional unit. A structural and functional unit. From here, all the basic things of the life starts. So here the definition living, what is the characteristics of living? So you can make the question also, when you will start from the book, we will go through the book and we will make the question as well as discussion from the each and every paragraph. Up here you make a question, define living. Define living. If you have a book from the pencil, you can write the question. Living organism shows growth, reproduction, ability to sense the environment. These are the characteristics, So now we will discuss whether these all characters is fit for the living things or not. The first is growth. Now see here, they have started. All living things grow. Of course, life of organism starts from the zygote, and this zygote divides and redivides to form an organism. It is due to growth and differentiation. If it is in the plant, radicle and plumule comes out and it grow into the plant. This is the growth, of course. A single cell organism also grows. Suppose it is amoeba, it divides into the many parts, it is also growth. The question arises that whether this, is it the chief characteristics? Of course, all living organisms grow. But what happens when we look for some non-living things, there is also a growth. As a mountain also grow, there is accumulation of sands of the growth is also there. If sand in the desert, you see here is a sand and there is a growth. It is also growing. Mountain is also growing. How you can say it is not a living, but growth is there. So the only growth cannot be the chief characteristics of the living. And what is the basic difference between the growth of living and non-living? Here you write the question and say, see here the mountains, boulders, sands will also grow. And so the non-living things also grow. But what is the basic difference? Question, you make the question.
They reproduce living things?
No, I'm not coming on the reproduction. That is also not a chief characteristic. I'm here up to this only I'm talking about growth. I will also talk about this in vitro. I have not talked. I will discuss about this. Because in chapter number one, what happens, so many things from the advance is given that creates a problem for the students. I will discuss this one. First, let me talk. We are only talking about the growth right now. We are not talking about another aspect. Question is, what is the basic difference? Yeah, differences.
Changes.
Differences in growth of living and non-living. Because though both are growing. Suppose I am asking this question. Write the differences of growth in living and non-living.
Living organisms show chemical changes.
That accumulates the material, not inside. See here, growth therefore, see here, in the non-living thing, there is accumulation of material. In non-living things, there is accumulation of material, but in living things, there is a growth from the inside. Actually, this protoplasm increases, that is protein increases. See here, answer is here. The non-living object accumulates the material on the surface. Living thing, growth from the inside. That you have to write and understand. If sands are there, they are accumulating, there is a growth is going on. But in the living things, what happens? There is a growth inside the cell, and when growth reaches a particular stage, it divides into two. So it can be a question. Growth, only growth cannot be the chief characteristics of the living things because non-living things also grow. Then question is that what is the difference? Difference is this one. In non-living, it is the accumulation of material. And in the living, it is from the inside. So from this question can be this. So I will discuss extra thing also, but you keep the book in front of you and from the pencil you mark it and make the question. So now the question arises here, in vitro. What they are telling? What do you mean by in vitro? Any of you? In vitro. See here, you all have studied IVF. From there you can record IVF. That is full form is in vitro fertilization. And non-technical word is also called as test tube baby. If you don't know, then and write in somewhere. So why this name is given and what they want to tell you here. Actually, it is a Latin word. In vitro means in artificial condition. In vitro means in artificial condition. It is a Latin word. Or in vivo means in original condition. So what they want, in now it is clear. So why this name IVF become popular? In vitro fertilization, matlab fertilization in artificial condition. This word is very popular because it due to in treatment of infertility, what happens? This egg is taken out from the outside and a sperm is also taken out from the outside, allowed to fuse in the laboratory condition. This is a treatment for infertility that you will study in the 12th class, chapter number 4, in detail. So here they are showing that organism can grow in vitro, means in artificial condition. Means if suppose you are taking a tube, and in tube you are taking certain chemical which is collectively called as culture media. Culture media is nothing but the food for the organism. And suppose you are adding a bacteria in it. This bacteria will start multiplying. It is multiplying in the artificial condition, so it is called as in vitro culture. In vitro culture. So in vitro culture, you can grow the bacteria. Any growth of the organism or the cell. Let us talk about this one. Growth of organism or cell in artificial condition. Do you know that human cell, blood cell can also grow? It is also in vitro culture. What happens due to certain reason? Human blood is taken out in the tube. Human blood is taken out in the tube and the cell only, of course, only YWBC lymphocyte grow. So it is also a growth. You are taken the blood, human blood, and it is multiplying in the artificial in vitro culture, it is also a growth. You can grow the bacteria, you can grow the yeast in the artificial condition. So artificial condition growth is required for so many purposes that we will discuss later. Yes, Sachin, you want to say something?
Sir, can you give a brief explanation
yes.
on notebook size?
Your voice is not very clear. Tell me again.
Sir, can you once more repeat about lymphocytes?
About?
Lymphocytes.
I am telling you lymphocytes. So, in what happens in, I am telling you, you have raised the voice from the, again, for the culture of the blood, human blood culture. You know, blood consists of RBC, WBC, and platelet. Detail we have to study in circulatory system. RBC, there is no nucleus, it do not grow. Platelet do not grow. In WBC, of many types, granulocytes and agranulocytes. The only type of blood cells multiply are lymphocyte. So lymphocyte is a type of WBC. Lymphocytes are type of WBC, and again it is of two types that we will study in circulatory system, B and T. So suppose you have to see the human chromosome for so many purposes, for detection of disease, that we will discuss in that chapter. Only lymphocyte can grow. So beta lymphocyte is a type of WBC, you can note it. Is it clear? And in culture, only lymphocyte grow. Other cells do not grow. And by growing this lymphocyte, one can study many genetic disorders. That's why I told you in this first chapter is accumulation of many things, many things. Clear? So it is clear that only lymphocytes grow in the artificial media. Why will you grow the blood cells? To detection of certain disease, and many purposes are required to grow the cell. But it is in vitro culture. In vitro culture means growth in artificial condition in the laboratory. Your blood cell can be grown. You can grow the bacteria is also grow, is allowed to grow. Because, you know, I'm telling you another common things. You might have studied when a person get ill. Person get ill. The doctor writes for urine culture and sensitivity. Urine culture, blood culture. Doctor writes for urine culture or blood culture to detect the certain E. coli infection or typhoid is there. So many things. Then what do we do in that case? You grow the urine. The urine do not grow. If the urine consists of bacteria, they grow in the petri plates. This is also artificial culture. It is applied in vitro culture, is applied in the medical science also for various purposes. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Well, now I have already started this point also. I have not, see here, each and every line has so many things for you people. So we have discussed up to this. From the next, we will start second point, reproduction. So if you have any question up to this, you can ask.